Hi, I'm Stefan List, Technical Marketing Architect at VMware. In this session, we will review the challenges our customers face when securing Linux servers and workstations. We will first see the difference between Windows security and Linux security, and then a lot of demonstrations. It will be technical, but don't worry, it will be easy to understand. So on Windows, there's a lot of malware, less on Linux, but there is more and more. The purpose of the endpoints is different. For example, you can easily reboot a Windows laptop, but for a Linux server, a web server, performance and uptime are very important. And finally, on Linux, there are a lot of daily updates of applications, kernel, and some companies use modified custom kernels. Carbon Black Sensor for Linux uses eBPF, Extended Berkeley Packet Filter. So it's already in all recent Linux kernel, version 4.4 and after. So it is safe, it is efficient, and doesn't require to change kernel source code or load kernel modules. So you can use custom Linux kernels. You just need to provide kernel headers to Carbon Black Sensor. So now let's go to the demo. For this first demo, I will use a Ubuntu server. On this server, I have a copy of VMware website. So it's fully a flat copy or static copy of the VMware website. And now imagine there is a malicious attacker that has been able to modify the source code or the PHP code or has been able to inject some code, in fact, in the website. What we could do? We could, for example, do an attack in PHP. And what the attack will be able to do, it can, in fact, with PHP, we can run any Linux command. So we can check the current directory. We can do WAMI. We can download an attack or ransomware or what you want from internet. So here, for example, this attack has downloaded attack.rgz. It has extracted the attack, and then it has executed the command. And as we can see here, we have a lot of image. And if we go back to the website, and we refresh the browser, we can see that the attack, in fact, has modified all images of the website. So, of course, on these Ubuntu endpoints, the Carbon Black Sensor is installed. Now let's go in the Carbon Black console to see how we can investigate on this incident. Now let's see Carbon Black Cloud console. In Carbon Black console, we have a dashboard with all alerts, and Carbon Black is an EDR. So with an EDR, we have some feeds, some watch lists. So it's really a collection of indicator of compromise. And in this indicator of compromise, we can, for example, look at Carbon Black endpoint suspicious indicators. Here we will see some indicator of compromise that have done some hits, so it has really matched with the indicator of compromise. And if I go in the detail, it was, for example, that the process name is Apache and the child process is WAMI or something else. So it is exactly what happened in our attack scenario. So let's investigate on this. We can see that it has happened twice. If we go to the process tree, we will see really the detail. We will see that Apache has run WAMI, then Apache has run, has downloaded a code from GitHub. So really, I would recommend to block the connection from your web server to GitHub, to Pastebin, or all other provider of service like this to share some malware or some binaries. Then in the attack, we can see that we have extracted the attack. And finally, the PHP file has run attack.sh. And we can really go to the detail. And in this attack.sh, we can see, okay, there has been a copy of a SQL image to one image. Once again, the copy of an image. So it is how the attack has been run on my Linux endpoint. Here, I really have the complete visibility. I have the timing. I have the name of the user, etc. So I know really everything. Now let's run another demo. In this demo, in fact, there is a malware and an attacker has access to your Linux server. I will show you the malware. So the malware is in four parts: malware, malware two, malware crypt, and malware end. So it begins with, in fact, malware.c that will disable security. So it will stop App Armor. It will disable the firewall. It will stop file to ban, etc. Then it will launch another binary, which it will be malware two. In this binary, then we will install some package. We will install nmap, rpscan, etc. So to really to discover all the network. It will also create a user named John. John will be added to the sudo group. So it will be a user for persistence to be able to come back on this Linux machine in the future. Then it will call another malware, malware crypt. This malware will install OpenSSL, will create a SSL key, will extract the public key in order to encrypt a file, file.txt. It will encrypt it in file.txt.crypted. Okay. At the end, we call malware end. Malware end will stop syslog, will remove all logs, will remove the history. So if you connect to your Linux endpoint after the attack, you really have no trace. You cannot understand you have really no visibility on your endpoint. So let's run this software. Oh, sorry, I need to make it before you compile it. You can really see the software. Sudo malware. But you can see disable App Armor, disable the firewall, stop fail to ban, install a Linux kernel module, then scan the network. Add a local account for the user John. Crypt some file, yeah, generate the key, crypt some file. And at the end, then we stop this log, we remove all traces, we remove all log. And if I look at my directory, I can see that my file, file.txt, is encrypted. It is, I can't read it anymore. So now let's take a look at Carbon Black console to see how we can hunt this threat with Carbon Black Cloud. So now we are back in Carbon Black Cloud console, still in the watch list. In the watch list, we can see that we have a lot of hits for different watch lists. For example, if I take the first one, I see there has been a, severity 6 IOC. So it is on Linux. There is a process RPC client that has run. Let's investigate this. I can see that it comes from Dash. If I try to go back and to analyze the root cause, I really easily find that it comes from malware, and I can really see everything that this malware has done on my endpoint. So it has added a user journal. It has disabled the firewall. It has checked for all mounted file systems, check for all partition, do a scan of the network, etc. And then it has run the malware crypt. So install OpenSSL, then generate a key to encrypt the file. So the encryption, yeah, it is to extract the public key to be able to encrypt the file. That's it. So really here you have the full visibility of what was running on your endpoint. You have been warned by, alerted by the watch list that something was wrong on your endpoint. And now you can take action. You can simply click on the malware, and then I can add it to banned list. When I add it to the banned list, I immediately see that this hash has been seen only on one device, so you have not been infected on other Linux endpoints. I can add it to the banned list. And if I try to run this malware again on my Linux machine, I will see that now it is blocked. Well, let's do it. So I'm back on my Linux system. If I try to execute again my malware, I see that it has been blocked. Operation not permitted. It has been blocked by Carbon Black. And if I go back on the console, now back to the Carbon Black Cloud console, I can see in alerts page that the application was detected running, a terminate policy action was applied. And if I go in the detail, I can see here that, yes, the process malware has been blocked. It is what I wanted to show you. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.